Welcome to What Are Record Types, the 9th video in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide admins the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. Users often need access to the same objects, but they gather and work with different data. You want your records to be customized so that users see only the business processes and fields relevant to them. This is where record types come in. These incredibly versatile tools help you collect and manage data about an object. For example, you may have one case object, but two variations, internal and external. Depending on the type of case, your users might need slightly different information and different picklist choices. Even the business processes they go through might be different. Record types are the answer. Record types let you offer different business processes, page layouts, and picklist values to different users. Business processes are represented by special picklist fields that capture the life cycle of a standard object, such as an opportunity, case, or a lead, or the life cycle of a custom object. Page layouts let you select and organize groups of fields related to an object. Picklist values are the lists of choices you define when you create a picklist field. You define a master list with all possible choices and use record types to display a subset depending on the situation. Let's take a look at this in the app. We'll create the business processes, page layouts, and record types we need for internal and external cases. Then we'll create and assign our picklist values. First, let's add any values we need to the status field. This field is used by case support processes. We type in any new field values we need for either internal or external cases and save. Then we'll go into the support processes to define the processes that are unique to each type of case. We'll create a process for internal support with unique status field values and an external support process adjusting status field values. Next, we'll create page layouts. We'll create the internal layout first. Back in the Object Manager, we'll select case page layouts, then new. If you're going to use custom fields, make sure you've created those before you create your case page layout. The custom fields we'll use in this example have already been created for us. We've got a field for case source, so we can know if the employee logging the case is at headquarters or in a satellite office. Let's drag that onto the layout along with case reason. We can't remove the contact field, but we can move it to a new section so it's out of the way. We'll save the internal layout. Now let's create the external layout. We'll base this on the existing case layout. We can add any necessary custom fields, delete fields we aren't using, and organize everything into sections. And save. Now we'll create two record types. From the case page within the Object Manager, click Record Types, then New. We name this record type internal, choose the internal support process we just defined, give it a description, and make sure it is active. Now let's make this record type available to the profiles that will use it. Only our support users create internal cases, so we'll select just that profile. On this screen, we'll choose which page layout to use. We'll select the internal page layout we just created and click Save and New. Now let's create the external record type. Both our inside sales reps and our support users create cases for customers, so we'll check both of their profiles and save. Next, we'll create all the picklist values we need. We'll go back to the field section and add some values to the type field. We can assign these values to the appropriate record type and save. The last thing we'll do is add the case record type field onto both the internal and external page layouts. This way, any user who has access to more than one record type can quickly see which type they're using. We go back to Page Layout Editor and edit both the internal and external layouts. Done. Let's log in as a support user to see what this looks like from the perspective of our end users. When Lars creates a new case, he can switch between the record types if necessary. The description field for each record type displays here, making it easy for him to choose. Selecting a record type provides Lars with the fields, picklist values, and business process he needs for that type of case. He isn't overwhelmed with choices he doesn't need or fields that don't apply. Here are some things to watch out for. Once you have created and assigned record types, you can edit those assignments by profile in the Manage Users Profile section of the setup pages. You can also assign custom record types via permission sets. If any records have already been created in your system before you created and started using record types, those original records won't have an associated record type. You'll need to retroactively assign the proper record type ID. You can use Data Loader to extract your cases. Be sure to include at least one of each record type so you have the ID. Then apply the correct record type ID and update the records using the Data Loader Update button. To learn more about visibility and access, check out all the videos in this series. Up next, we'll dive into restriction rules. You can also search for these topics in Salesforce Help, or come join us on the trail at trailhead.salesforce.com. Thanks for watching.